Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to avoid common problems with transparency in Unreal Engine 4. On the screen you can see two meshes with opacity set to 100%, so they both should look the same, but the mesh on the left is definitely different. It has bad sorting of polygons. The Unreal Engine logo is not visible. The mesh on the left has translucency enabled, while the mesh on the right, I mean its material, is opaque. The blend mode on the left mesh is set to translucent, while the second mesh is opaque. So, as you can see, enabling translucency changes the look of the object, even if the opacity is set to 100%. Probably that's an issue that you encountered quite often. How can we deal with it? We can use a trick that comes straight from the 80s or early 90s. It's alpha dithering, or screen door transparency. It's also a name I encountered once. Well, dithering is emulating an appearance of a smooth gradient or a smooth value, like for example a slight gray or a dark gray, with a fewer amount of colors or shades. So here we could use still the solid mesh and emulate the transparency by dithering its alpha with only two values, completely transparent and completely opaque, so 0 and 1. There is a mode for that, masked, so we replace translucent with masked. Now obviously nothing happened, because in masked you have to specify opacity mask, not opacity. If we just moved our opacity to the opacity mask, it still won't be what we need, because it's either 1, completely opaque, or 0, completely invisible. As you can see, at least the appearance changed. It looks like a proper solid mesh. The appearance is identical to the regular solid mesh, opaque mesh. Now we need to enable dithering. There's a node that is called dither temporal AA. It refers to temporal anti-aliasing used in post-process by Unreal, so it will smoothen out the 0-1 mask. Let's place it in between the opacity and opacity mask, with the opacity values put into the alpha threshold slot. And that's it. Now our left mesh is properly vanishing, almost like it was a normal translucency. You can probably see some pattern, but it's completely fine. In full HD, it would be even better. So, why is it so hard to use normal translucency for an engine compared to an opaque mesh with a mask? Well, it's because how modern game engines do rendering. Before the generation of Xbox 360 and PS3, the most commonplace technique was called forward rendering. Currently, the mainstream technique is called deferred rendering. I will explain the deferred technique by showing you the buffers that Unreal Engine uses for that. The view mode, buffer visualization. You can see all of the buffers. For example, base color, world normal. All the lighting is done on the second pass. The first pass is just writing values for every pixel into the buffers, like roughness, the base color. So instead of wasting the computation time for every polygon, every vertex, and every light in the scene, we only use the information that comes from the screen's pixels. Thanks to that, in modern game engines you can have hundreds of small lights in the scene. It will be super hard to do with forward techniques. But there's a disadvantage to this. As you can see in the world normal pass, we only store values for the closest mesh, closest pixel to the camera. So what about the rocks that are behind our objects? For deferred rendering, they are completely invisible. They don't exist. And that's a huge problem, because we calculate light only for what we see. If we want to have some transparency, we would have no information for the rocks behind to get lit. So, how Unreal Engine solves this kind of a problem? Well, it renders the transparent meshes in forward mode, then combines the result with the deferred rendered background. When we go back to lit, it's here, but definitely looks different. It's rendered with a different technique. So, what we did is using a standard masked mode instead of the translucent mode, Thanks to this, Unreal Engine can still stick to its dithered rendering path for the object. It looks identical to the normal opaque mesh, just masked by a dithered mask, which is either 0 or 1. In motion, with anti-aliasing applied, it will be very hard to notice, especially in high resolutions. And the additional benefit of using this technique is much higher performance of the meshes compared to translucency. Thank you for your time and good luck with your projects.